Hey guys, Carissa Rose here. For this video, I'm going to be quote unquote painting with Sharpie markers. So I've seen a couple of really cool videos here and there on YouTube where people will take Sharpie markers and draw with them on canvas and then dilute them with rubbing alcohol, and it makes the ink kind of run and has a really cool effect. I wasn't really sure how the Sharpie markers were going to react with the rubbing alcohol when I first started doing it, so I'm kind of learning as I go in this piece. I had expected the Sharpies and rubbing alcohol to be kind of like watercolors, but it actually ended up being like a lot different. The rubbing alcohol seemed to really push away the color, and certain Sharpies would blend a lot better with the rubbing alcohol, and other ones wouldn't blend so much at all. So it was really an experimental process as I was trying it out. The rubbing alcohol also had a way of really like expanding unexpectedly on the canvas. I'm not sure if it was because of the texture of it or just like how, if that's just what rubbing alcohol does, but it was definitely way different than what I expected, which was, you know, more of like a water consistency, but it was totally different. Also, the rubbing alcohol took a lot longer to dry in between than water would on watercolor paper. I just had to wait longer in between. I didn't really record the whole time it was drying because it probably would have took a while. And the other thing I didn't really account for when I was making this was just how much the fumes from the rubbing alcohol affected me. By the time I'd worked on this for about 3 or 4 hours straight when I first started working on it, and it just gave me such a bad headache by the time I was done, but I didn't even like realize it during it. So word of caution, if you're gonna try out any painting with alcohol, make sure that it's a well fumigated area, I believe is the word. Definitely have like a window open or something, or try to do it outdoors if possible. Oh, and I miss saying this over the part with the painter's tape. I tried to put a little bit of painter's tape on it so I could get like spots left open for highlights later, but as soon as I put the rubbing alcohol on the canvas, it just made the painter's tape come right off. There's probably some better sort of tape. I think I saw something about like plumbing tape or something like that. But I don't know, this was my first time trying it, so I'll have to try it again with different tape next time. So this piece is sped up to about 40 times speed. It took me like 4 hours about to do the piece in real time, not including all the time waiting in between to dry. So for most of this piece, I was drying with the Sharpie first and then going over with rubbing alcohol to get it to spread out. But then at some point, I decided to put a piece of clear tape on my table, and I drew on the tape with the Sharpie and then took some rubbing alcohol and picked up the Sharpie color from the tape. And that worked a little bit more like watercolors, but it's still totally different consistency. But I was able to do a splatter effect doing that, whereas you can't really get a splatter when you're drawing on it with Sharpie and then going over with alcohol. And then whenever I painted pretty much anything, I had to sit and wait for the rubbing alcohol to dry, because I couldn't draw on the canvas when the rubbing alcohol was still wet, because the Sharpie wouldn't even put down like any color. I'd wait for it to completely dry in between every time drawing. And also, having the thick layers of Sharpie with the rubbing alcohol did make it more difficult to go over with Sharpie. I'd use like 3 different black Sharpies whenever I was putting black down, because one would stop working for a second and I'd have to let it sit off to the side while I grabbed a different one to try to do a little bit more. Especially with getting like the fine lines with the eyelashes, I needed to have sharp tipped Sharpies, I guess would be the way to say it. So I guess if I were making a review for painting with Sharpies, I'd give it like a 3 out of 5 stars. It's pretty difficult. Definitely way harder than watercolors, and it just, like, it works really weirdly. Like, I'd have to really get used to it to keep doing more stuff with it. I mean, on the plus side, you get some really, really cool vivid colors, and you can really definitely do some cool effects by dripping rubbing alcohol. I didn't have, like, a eye drop dripper that I've seen other people use for painting with Sharpies and rubbing alcohol, so I took a drinking straw and, like, put it down in the rubbing alcohol a little bit and then held the top so the pressure would, like, keep it in the straw and use that as, like, a kind of makeshift dripper. It worked okay. But as far as painting more realistic stuff goes, it is definitely more difficult trying this Sharpie method. And now at the end here, I'm putting in some white highlights with acrylic paint, as I usually do with most of my pieces. It always helps the picture pop. And I think that'll probably be about it right there. And there's the piece I'll finish. As you can see, when I turn it in the light, it's really, really shiny and reflective, because Sharpies tend to have that kind of shine to them on canvas. Well, thanks so much for checking out my video. If you liked it, be sure to check out some of my other painting and drawing videos on my channel. And if you have any suggestions for anything you'd like to see in the future, be sure to let me know in a comment. You can check out the description for links to my Facebook, Instagram, and my Etsy store, where I sell prints, originals, and more. Well, see you guys later. Toodles!